than a Christian, a better plumber, a better CPA than a Christian. Mind you, out of alignment. That's incongruent. What are you doing for God? You can be so busy with the important things of life that you miss the necessary things of eternity. That's quotable. You can be so busy with the important things of life that you miss the necessary things of eternity. Someone needs to hear your voice. Look at someone and say, someone needs to hear your voice. Yes, someone needs to stand up and let them hear your voice. Not when you're giving them a piece of your mind, but when you're telling them about Jesus Christ. Someone needs to see your face. Someone needs to hold your hand, or you need to hold somebody's hand. But these must all be done in the context of your assignment from God. Here's the assignment given by Jesus, Mark 16:15. Into all the world. Preach the gospel to every creature. So Woody and I are sharing that when you preach God's word, you can't get in trouble. You people don't have to be a fact, see, right? But our story is not when you preach God's word, you're plumbing your man. The third thing, as I hasten to close, the third thing that qualified Paul was that he knew both his assignment and life would come to an end. In the natural, we work until it is time to retire. For some, they may seek early retirement, while others opt for mandatory retirement. And then there are those who refuse to see the signs, and they die without ever enjoying their hard-earned benefits. Stop working so hard, you know? And take a vacation. Can I speak to this church? This man in my daughter was in my spirit. Stop working so hard. Let your blood pressure come down. Glory be to God. Sit down long enough to get a proper meal. Stop eating foolish food and behaving foolishly. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. I do that in the devil's business now, but I need to help us today and understand that this life is bigger and more precious than what we sum it up to be. Go on vacation. Tell your little wife, I love you. Tell your husband, I appreciate you. Tell your children, I forgive you. Or let them tell you they forgive you. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. We can't take anything for our joy. Can I preach this? We can't take anything for our joy. Some of us are sitting down in here and we are in trouble with God and we are in trouble with our families. Get it right in the name. So help me, Holy Ghost. If you need to get forgiveness, then get it in the name of Jesus. If you need to make confession, then make the confession in the name of Jesus. Don't let anything stop you from going to God's eternal paradise. And if the person that you offended is not in this church, when you leave this place today, go and find them before you go to bamboo shack and say, I love you. Forgive me for all that I ever did to you. Resentment, hatred, and hostility. Give God a challenge, and God can deal with it. Am I speaking to any families in this place? Get it right. Get it right. Sometimes you see cracks in families at funerals. You hear the horror stories. You see the unchristian and uncharitable behavior, and you wonder, you mean these people really saved? So called, they said they're saved. But when you come to God, you can leave from God. Spirit and the right attitude. And let me tell you something, As sure as night follows day, we will all come to an end. Ecclesiastes 9 and 5, as I hasten to take my seat, just for the living, no, they shall die. But the dead know not anything. Neither have they any more of their reward, for the memory of them is forgotten. The living know they shall die. Every time I come to a funeral where someone is 58 or in that 50 category between 50 and 60, I get a quick reminder the living, especially if I'm conducting the funeral. I'd be like, wow. I see my little hairline receding, the living know. The more I exercise, it seems that the more plump I get, the living know. I'm starting to tell old stories more and more, the living know. I'm starting to drive in areas where I used to drive many years ago, the living know. I'm trying to sometimes think about how my food will be, the living know. And I look at some of you and I see you trying to kind of push back against the age, but when you push this way, it slips out the next way. And you push your hand and everything, but age, the caraway has a way of coming up. The living know they must die. Woman said to me, Bishop Woodley, woman said to me, Mr. Hanna, I don't read Thursday's paper. I knew why, but I wanted to ask her. I said, why? Every time I look at the papers on Thursday, oh, and I see people who my age, I don't, Mr. Hanna, I know my life. And I said to myself, what a big fool this woman is. The living know, they must die, or they shall die. And the fourth and final thing is, the qualified poor to make this statement, he understood. When this life is ended, there is a larger life on the other side. Can you tell someone there is a larger life? Yeah, there have been people talking badly about you now. There is a larger life. There, with not having all the T's crossed and the I's dotted in this life, there is a larger life. There have been people who don't understand you when you want to do what you want to do. There is a larger life. You may not have now, but there is a larger life, and our quest is to get to the larger life. Some of you have been serving God for many, many years, and you keep wondering, when will these things end? I do my best, and people speak poorly about me. Keep serving God. Put your sticky hand in somebody's hand. Keep serving God. Get ready to pray. Terrence's praise team, be not deceived. God is is not marked. But you don't know church people. Yeah, I know church people. I know church people. Look what he did for me. Scum of the earth. Scoundrel. Cleaned me up. Saved me. Gave me a name. Gave me substance. My reality to be your reality. Scripture tells us the wages of sin is death. The gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior, the end is nearly. Hallelujah. I recap quickly by calling on all of us to look again in our relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. So when I don't feel saved, salvation is more than a feeling. It's an experience. I ask you to become reacquainted with your assignment. But you know, we say, Mama, I'm young. My family and my needs are such that they keep me going. Take time to be holy. Take time to do God's work. As I reflect, know your assignment. I know that your life will one day come to an end. And you may be able to bluff your way through things on this side. When you stand before the eternal bar, and you have to look a righteous God in the face. What is so wonderful about God is God asks you to bring no evidence. When you come, he simply opened the book. He opened the book. And then, by God's faith, when he opens the book, you know, sometimes we are very creative in the truth. The book, Christine, you're going to be able to say, yep, that's me. That's me. It may be a department, but that's me. It's me. But we can cancel all of that in the name of Jesus by coming into a personal relationship with him. And so, I'm going to ask you to join hands with each other and close your eyes. If you want to receive Jesus Christ as your Savior, just put your hand up and put it back down real quickly. In the name of Jesus, I see that hand. Bless you. Anybody else want to receive? I see that hand. God bless you. I see that hand. God bless you. Hallelujah. Anybody else? Yes. With your head bowed. I see that hand. God bless you. That's about 5 persons. I know that there are more. Hallelujah. Join in this prayer, repeat after me, to give our friends the comfort to know that we are in solidarity with them as they come to know Jesus Christ as Savior. Would you repeat after me? Dear Lord God, I come to you today, a sinner.